Well, today is extra special. I have got Matt Prologo in the kitchen with me. Now, Matt said to me when I ran into him at lunch one day, you know, I should come on and make my family's recipe of Braciole. I said, okay, you know, and then I talked to him. We went over all the ingredients. Of course, it's your dad's recipe.
It's my dad's recipe. Yeah.
And, you know, usually I will give you the full ingredient list, but I have to watch him, and I'm going to get a general idea of amounts because we know little this, little that, and it was all eyeballed when your dad made it.
Yeah.
And this is pretty much all the ingredients. And I, growing up with my Italian neighbors, this was kind of a special occasion dish.
Yeah.
But no, not in your family. You throw it down.
Well, yeah. My dad loved this. He loved to make it. He loved the whole process of making it. And but then, like, you know, whenever he felt like it, he would go get it and make it, you know, which was quite often.
You want to get started? We start here at the counter.
So first we want to just pepper this up a little bit.
Nice. All
put
right.
A little pepper on here. Okay. And then what I'd like to do, if we want to start the mixing bowl. So we got the, now you can use breadcrumbs. I like the panko, Italian panko. You know, to me it's a little.
I went and got all the ingredients that Matt demanded.
Yeah, it's a little.
And okay. Then, and then.
The Parmesan.
Parmesan. I got the shaved. I hope it's to your liking.
Shave will work.
Okay. And then this cheese.
Then, yeah, that's a provolone mozzarella.
Mixture.
Shred it. You want to shred the provolone and mozzarella. And then we got half a cup of parsley. Chopped parsley.
Chopped. He likes the curly. I bought the Italian.
Yeah, I think the curly got a little more flavor.
Okay.
And then a quarter cup of oregano.
Basil,
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Chopped.
All right.
And then this is what I'm going to do with the garlic. I like to do. My dad would always sprinkle a little bit like this.
I love garlic. You can't have enough garlic.
Can't have enough garlic. You know, get a little bit like that. Okay. And then the rest goes in there.
All right. Okay.
All right. And then we do a little bit of the, we throw an egg in there just to bind it.
Okay.
You know, with a little olive oil.
All right.
And then we can mix that up a little bit.
All right, you want me to do that?
Yeah. Okay. You mix that up, and then what I'm going to do is lay the prosciutto down.
Okay.
Now, some like to chop the prosciutto and throw it in the mixture, you know, when it's all in, you know, so it's all together, but my dad liked to layer it all out on his own, you know.
Well, I think it disintegrates almost. Because it's the real thin, and it'll add that nice bit of fat to it.
Absolutely. That's where the flavor comes in. Okay, and then what you want to do is we want to lay that out onto the braciole. Just spread it out there.
It like in one hunk?
Yeah.
Well, one right hunk in the middle?
Right in the middle, and I'll smooth it out.
Okay, you'll move it out. Okay, let me get to the rest.
What we
want to
do is this. This is how we want to do it.
Oh, like that? Sorry.
We'll spread it out like that, yeah.
All right.
We do this. We want a quarter, two hard-boiled eggs.
All righty.
And then lay them down like this. Right at the end that you're going to start the roll in.
Okay.
You want to lay these eggs down like this, and it throws a little bit more flavor into the piece when we're cooking.
Oh, I was wondering what the heck we're gonna do with those.
We're gonna throw these down here. You know, you just got to start the roll here. Okay.
I mean, you did do a nice job. That is a nice thin piece of meat, easy to work with.
Thin piece of meat. Okay. But another thing that I wanted to point out was when you're pounding this out and you're rolling it, okay, you want the grain of the meat is going from me left to right. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So you don't want to roll the grain, so when you cut it, okay, you're cutting
against the grain.
If you roll this the other way, when you cut it, it'll shred, it'll be like cutting, you know, shoe leather. After we mix it up, roll the log. What we want to do is sear it. So you can sear it in some hot oil.
Okay.
This is going to.
I know, the pan. Oh, it laid in pretty good.
Yeah, it laid in pretty good. Okay. So after we take that out.
Now we're going to keep using this oil though, right?
I'm going to throw this oil right in here.
Now what do you want this on?
I'll put that on medium low.
Okay. Now we're going to cook this stovetop.
Yeah.
Because we can.
Yeah.
Because my mom happens to have.
This is where you want to put, as you want to get these onions caramelized in here.
Okay, and that's using the same olive oil.
Same olive oil, yeah, from the beef.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Nice.
And then what I like to do, a cup of wine.
Okay. Beautiful.
That's a cup. You think that's a cup?
Yeah. We'll use a whole can.
Then you want to do the whole can of sauce. Just pour it right over top of that.
Okay.
You know? And if you want to, you know what? There's two things you can do with this. You can cook this like this with this can.
Okay.
And you know what? Maybe a little water in there.
All right. Okay. About how much?
Maybe a quarter of a can. Okay.
Okay. And that way it gets the rest of the juice out too.
Yeah. So, okay. You know, normally...
Is that enough?
That's enough. You throw it right on top of that.
On top?
Yeah. Okay. And then we're going to do, now we can do a little salt and pepper just to season this a little bit.
Okay.
Okay.
Beautiful.
You know, what we normally do on a Sunday, okay, is this would cook in the sauce, you know,
okay.
your Sunday gravy. This way you do it, if we want to throw another can of crushed tomatoes in there, what you can do is, after you're done cooking this braciole, after that we're going to put a lid on it. Here.
And we're going to cook this stovetop.
Stovetop about hour 20 minutes.
Do you have to keep opening and checking
no.
it? Or you just let it?
I just let it cook.
Set it in there.
Let it cook.
Okay.
And then, but you can add some more sauce and make that, you know, maybe even make a little half pound of pasta and.
Oh, and then you already got your pasta sauce.
And so then
sauce
you got
made.
Your pasta sauce made.
Well, you saw that we added another can of crushed tomatoes about a half hour before the braciole was done.
Right.
So now we had enough to make pasta sauce. So we did a little angel hair, and this looks beautiful. Really, Matt, this looks
Thank you.
Perfectly done.
It smells good, too.
And I pulled out a bottle of my Better Homemade. I just got this from Frank Rigetti. He and his brother, Bobby Remedio, made a batch.
This is
so
good.
And I want to share this with you.
And we did use a little in the recipe.
In the sauce.
We had to use a little in the recipe.
Thank you, Franklin. And it's really good homemade bread. And I'm dying to try your braciole.
Oh,
it's tender. Okay.
That's really tender.
Perfectly done.
Mm-hmm.
Perfectly done. But go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com, and look for this recipe. And Matt, you are coming back, right?
Oh, yes.
We have been talking.
We got more recipes to do.
A lot more to make, and we're going to share them with you. And I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Matt.